and R1 is its internal resistance. Now here its EMF is E2 and R2 is the internal resistance. Now I can write the equation as VA minus VB is equal to E1 minus I1 R1. What is I1? Suppose I current is coming here, it will be branchized. So I1 current through cell E1 and I2 through E2. Now this is one equation. Next, if I follow this path, I can get this equation. I can also follow this path. In that case, VA minus VB is equal to E2 minus I2 R2. So this is first equation, this is second equation. Now we know that if you consider VA minus VB as V then I1 is equal to E1 minus V by R1. Similarly, I2 is equal to E2 minus V by R2. We know that I is only divided into I1 and I2. Therefore, sum of I1 plus I2 must be equal to I. Therefore, I can be written as E1 by R1, and if I take this one, E2 by R2 minus V by R1 minus V by R2. Or I can write E1 R2 plus E2 R1 by R1 R2, and this is 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So this is all equal to I. Now if we write an equivalent circuit as E as resultant EMF and R as resultant internal resistance, then we can write VA minus VB, which we are considering V, as E minus I times R. Now if we calculate I from this equation, E by R minus V by R. Now if we compare this equation and this equation, this 1 by R is equal to (1/R1) + (1/R2), which gives us R is equal to (R1/R2) / (R1+R2). Now by comparing this, the first part, E by R is equal to (E1/R2) + (E2/R1) / (R1/R2). Now what we can do is we can shift this R to this side. Then what happens? E is equal to (E1/R2) + (E2/R1) / (R1/R2), when this r goes to the numerator, we can find out, we can put up the value as r1 r2 by r1 plus r2. I can cancel out this, and finally the value of e is equal to e1 r2 plus e2 r1 by r1 plus r2. This is the net EMF and this is the net resistance. So this is the equivalent arrangement of when two cells are connected in parallel.